In the 375th verse, Shankaracharya says, अत्यंत वैराग्यवतः समाधिः समाहितस्यैव दृढप्रबोधः प्रबुद्ध तत्वस्य हि बंधमुक्तिः मुक्तात्मनो नित्यसुख अनुभूतिः. So he says that अत्यंत वैराग्यवतः समाधिः, a person who has got extreme dispassion, a person who is having lot of dispassion, only that person can have samadhi. What is samadhi? Samadhi has got two broad stages. Roughly you can say two broad stages are there of samadhi. One is called nirvikalpa samadhi, which is the highest state. Another one is savikalpa samadhi, which is the second state, the second highest stage. What is savikalpa samadhi? Where some concept or form is held on to. And nirvikalpa samadhi has complete dissolution of the mind. That is what is called nirvikalpa samadhi. So here Shankaracharya says atyanta means complete or extreme, absolute vairagya vataha, a person who has got dispassion completely, only that person has got samadhi. And only such a person, so complete dispassion means that person will have no attachment to any kind of enjoyment or any kind of idea that one is the doer and one is the enjoyer. This has to be there. Samahitasyaiva dhrida prabodha. And only a person who has got samadhi, only a person who has got complete control over one's mind can be dhrida prabodha, can get steady knowledge. Prabodha means knowledge. Can get steady knowledge of what? Of one's true personality. Of one's true personality, that who am I? Prabuddha tattvasya hi bandha mukti hi. And only a person who has realized the truth can be free from bandha, can be free from bondage. What kind of bondage? Bondage of repeated birth and death. Bondage of coming into this world, taking birth into this world. A person can be free from that only if that person has realized truth. And muktaatmanah nitya sukha anubhutihi. And only a person who has realized one's true nature can be constantly happy, have eternal bliss. So that is what is being told. So it all starts with extreme dispassion. You should have extreme dispassion. With extreme dispassion will come samadhi. With samadhi will come constant knowledge. What is covering our knowledge is desire. Ignorance in the form of desire. So if samadhi is there, then your mind comes under control. And then a person who has realized the truth becomes free. And then that person who becomes free gets experience of one's true self, eternal bliss, nitya sukha anubhuti. Then one's bliss or happiness is not dependent upon any kind of external pleasure, external enjoyment. Then Shankaracharya says, Vairagyat na param sukhasya janakam pashyami vashyatmanah tachet shuddha taratma bodha sahitam swarajya samrajya duk etad dwaram ajasra mukti yuvatehe yasmat tvam asmat param. Sarvatra Asprihaya Sadatmani Sada Pragnyam Kuru Shreyase. Now, as is the trend of Shankaracharya in this text, he becomes very poetic and he gives lot of examples. What example does he give? Here he gives a different kind of example. He says, Vairagyatna Param Sukhasya Janakam Pashyami. I don't Vashyatmana hai. For a person who is Vashyatmana, a person who has controlled one's self, for a person whose mind is under one's control, Shankaracharya says, I don't see any other happiness greater than Vairagya. I don't see any other cause of happiness. Janakam. Janaka means father or one who gives birth. So I don't see anything other than Vairagya that can cause or that can become the instrument for Sukha, Param Sukha, of great happiness. So I see only Vairagya, which is the great happiness. So for a person who is of self-control, Vairagyatna Param Sukhasya Janakam Pashyami, Vashyatmanaha. A person here, Atmanaha, means it refers to mind and also sense organs. So, Atma, this word can refer to many things. Here it means mind and sense organs. So a person who has controlled one's mind and sense organs, Vashyatmanaha, has brought them under one's Vasha, control. For that person, Vairagyatna Param Sukhasya Janakam. There is no other cause of Param Sukha, great bliss, other than dispassion. What is dispassion? That I don't want to enjoy these things. I don't want to have these things. So that kind of idea. And Tachet, if there is Shuddha Taratma Bodha Sahitam, Sahitam, if it is combined with Shuddha Taratma Bodha, Shuddha Tara Atma Bodha, if it is combined with realization of self, self-realization, which is Shuddha Tara, which is very pure, highly pure, the purest, then what happens? Swarajya Samrajya Dukh. It makes you become the emperor, makes you become the controller, sovereign of Swarajya, of your own self. Swarajya. Swarajya means your own kingdom. Your own kingdom, self-dominion. So Swarajya, there is a text called Swarajya Siddhi. There are, in Advaita Vedanta, there are 5 texts which are called Siddhi texts. One is Advaita Siddhi, then there is Ishta Siddhi, then there is Brahma Siddhi, then there is Naishkarmya Siddhi, there is Swarajya Siddhi. So the Swarajya Siddhi, what does it mean? That you will attain your own kingdom. What is your own kingdom? Where you don't have to depend on anybody else. So, Swarajya Samrajya. This is a kingdom, Samrajya, empire. But what kind of empire? Which is your own empire. Where you don't have to depend on somebody else. That is your empire. And Swarajya Samrajya Dukh. And you can, with full independence, you can live in that empire. Live means not live like we live, going behind sense objects or sense pleasures. But you have no dependence on anything else. That kind of empire. So Swarajya Samrajya Dukh. You can be, if you have a controlled mind, and if you have dispassion along with that controlled mind, and if you have the knowledge of self, if you have these 3 things. So unless you control your mind, you will not have dispassion. Unless you have dispassion, you will not have knowledge of yourself. But if you have all these 3 things, then Swarajya Samrajya Dukh, you will be able to. It will help you. It will help you to attain this Swarajya Samrajya. this empire of your own kingdom. It will help you to attain this empire of your own kingdom. And also what will happen? Etad dwaram. And also this will become the gateway, dwaram. This will be become the door for what? Ajasram mukti. Ajasra mukti. This will become the gateway for mukti. What kind of mukti? Everlasting mukti. Mukti is what kind of mukti? A person is born and does some mistake or does not do some mistake. Does something and then person is simply put on a false complaint and police lodges a FIR against that person and then that person is jailed, arrested and put in prison. So what happened? This person got into prison, jail. And then some people go, etc., etc., advocate goes, etc., and then brings out that person from prison, jail. And then what happens? Now this person has become free. But has that person really become free? No. Because he has or she has been born into this world, this ignorance. So this is not everlasting liberation. Some people, they think, oh, I will come out of my house and then at least for 1 week I will be free from my wife's nagging. Or husband thinks that I will be, wife thinks I will be free from husband's nagging. Or she also thinks, let him go for 1 week, some business tour. I will also be happy and he will also be happy. So that is not everlasting mukti because again it will come. Or in the Bhagavad Gita it is told that if somebody does punya, does good acts, then this person will go to big worlds, will get good merits, and so this person will have good life, etc. But shine punye martya lokam vishanti. Once that punya, that balance of that merit or good work goes away, this person will fall again. Martya lokam vishanti. Vishanti means fall. Will come down to this world, take birth again. So it is only like that. Till you have money, all your friends, your relatives, everybody will come and say, oh, how are you, etc. The moment your money will go away, nobody will bother. So that is how it is. This mukti is not like that. This mukti is ajasra mukti. It is everlasting. It will never come to end. Ajasra means which has got no end. Akshaya, which has got no destruction. That kind of liberation. Once you are liberated, you are liberated. You don't have, there is no condition for this liberation. You have complete liberation. So, that is what is being told. And so, how is it being compared? Ajasra mukti yuvatehe yasmat tvam asmat param. And this ajasra mukti is like a yuvati, like a young woman who is very beautiful. Of course, it is written from a male perspective. So if a woman reads it, what young woman with beautiful. But anyway, the idea is like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He used to go on the streets and say that, what he used to say? Magur Machar Jol, Juvati Mer Kol. So the fish, there is this fish Magur and this Jol, the soup of this fish, which is very tasty to eat. Depends of course who cooks, but generally well cooked, it is tasty to eat. And Juvati Mer Kol, and the lap of a young woman. So he used to say like that. And people used to listen, what is this? This like advertisement tactic. You have to sell a fridge, put a young woman beside. If you have to sell a car, put a young woman beside. There is no connection between that young woman and the fridge and the car. But put, anyway put. Because, and some of people will be, oh, this great, this actress. And they will look at the actress and they forget. But anyway, such things. Or if you want to sell Pepsi or any other such soft drinks, make one big celebrity come and drink it. Then that's all, it will sell. So like that, these old people also have done all that things. You see, Shankaracharya is also doing. Later on, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is also doing. Juvati Mer Kol. Then somebody goes and near and listens, what is this? Then Hari Bol, Hari Bol. What kind of all these people are not dependable, huh? Anyway, so then Shankaracharya also is saying, it is like yuvati yuvatehe. This mukti is like attaining some young woman. Yasmat tvam asmat param. And therefore, you have to give up this world. Why? Because of your welfare. Because of your welfare. Yasmat tvam asmat param. You give up everything external and internal. You give up. Sarvatra, everywhere, externally and internally. Asprihaya, without any spriha, means any attachment. So, dispassionately, give up external and internal. Don't have any attachment. Dispassionately give up external and internal. Sadatmani sada pragyam kuru shreyase. And sadatmani, and always fix your mind in sada sadatmani sada pragyam kuru shreyase. And for your own welfare, for your shreyas. So there are two things in life. One is the preferable and another one is the pleasurable. Shreyaha preyaha. Shreyaha is the preferable and preyaha is the pleasurable. So we get this in the Upanishads, that you have these two concepts of, one is the preferable, another one is the pleasurable. What do? We always opt for the pleasurable. We go for that which gives us pleasure, which may not be good for us, but which gives us pleasure. We go for that. And that which is good for us, we may know, but we don't do that. We don't do that. So, sarvatra asprihaya sadatmani sada pragyam kuru shreyase. So, sada pragyam kuru shreyase. For your shreyase, for your own welfare, kuru, what? Pragyam sadatmani. Always sadatmani pragyam kuru. Always constantly think of yourself. How should you think of yourself? Self means not this body, mind, but Atman. How you should think? By giving up everything, attachment to everything, external and internal. Sarvatra, giving up attachment to everything. So for Tasmat Shreyase, for your own good, please think of your true personality. Asham Chindi Visha Upameshu Visheshu Vishesh Vaishaiva Mrityoho Kritihi Tyaktva Jati Kulashrameshu Abhimatim Munchati Durat Kriyaha Dehada Vasati Tejatma Dishanam Pragnyam Kurushvatmani Tvam Drashtasya Manosi Nirdvaya Param Brahmasi Yad Vastutaha. Asham Chindi Vishopameshu. So, Asham Chindi Vishayeshu. You give up Chindi, cut. Chindi means to cut, sever, cut. You cut Asha, any kind of expectation or hope or craving, hankering for Vishayeshu, for sense objects. So stop having any kind of expectation for sense objects. Don't have any expectation for sense objects. Why? It is like Visha Upameshu. It is like Visha, like poison. It is like poison. And it is also Veshaiva Mrityoho Kritihi. It is like the Vesha of Mrityu, that is death. It has taken the form of death. So all these people everywhere, you are given, suppose you are working somewhere, you have a post, So if you think I have got some post and I will do something, or I have got a post so I am great, etc., that will create you problem. Why? Because every time you will be thinking, I should not lose the post. So you suppose even a child gets a toy. The moment you give a child a toy, afterwards you ask the child the toy, the child will not give. Child will not be able to give. Child will say, no, I will not give. And it is mine. And then if you try to take the toy, then the child will start crying. And then so much hullabaloo will be there. So why? Because that attachment has been made. So we have so many toys in this world and attachment. We always see that I am this object. It is my object. This is mine. So I should have this, etc. So what is being told? Cut that expectation. Ashahi paramam dukkham, nairashyam paramam sukham. It is told that hope is the cause of greatest suffering. Ashahi paramam dukkham. It is the cause of greatest suffering. And nairashyam paramam sukham. And if you don't have any hope, that means if you have unattachment, if you have no expectation, that is good. That is the cause of great happiness. So you give up this hope, give up asha, don't have any kind of asha, don't have any hope. Why? Because it is like poison. What does poison do to us? It kills us. So it is like the image, vesha, it is of the form of mrityu, it is of the form of death. Mrityoho kritihi. So give this up. Tyaktva jati kula ashrameshu abhimatim. Your abhimati, your pride to jati, to the caste, kula, to the lineage you have been born into, family, and ashrama. According to the traditional Indian system of life, society, we have four stations of life, ashrama. One is brahmacharya ashrama, grihastha ashrama, then vanaprastha ashrama and sannyasa ashrama. So this, you give up the state of life in which you are. So now what happens? Brahmacharya is when a person studies, and grihastha ashrama is when the person is married and has to look after the family and all that. Vanaprastha is when that person is sent to old age home, and sannyasa ashrama is not existing. Nobody goes for sannyasa. Old age home itself, they are happy. So, or they have to live like they are happy. So this jati kula ashrama ashrameshu abhimatim, you give up your pride, your attachment, your identification with this jati, caste, and family, and also the ashrama. And muncha ati durat kriyaha, and give up all actions. You just throw them at a distance. Suppose you are, say, going in dark, and suppose you come, say, to this room in the dark and see the table, and say, suppose here one snake is there. And you are simply groping in the dark, what is there? And you find one snake. Then you understand it is a snake. Then you will throw like that. Once you understand that it is something snake, something dangerous, you immediately, you shake your body and throw it. So it is poison. The sense objects are poison. Understand that and throw it away. Throw all the actions away. What kind of actions are being talked here? Here, sakama karma. All kinds of actions which are done with a goal to attain some selfish motive, they have to be thrown to a distance. Swamiji came with a new ideal of karma. He said, whatever, even if you breathe, that is also action. So you will have to do action, but instead of doing it selfishly, do it unselfishly. And then just by doing karma yoga, you will be able to attain God. But we don't understand the implication. It is not so easy. Swamiji says, I will walk on all fours to the corners, all corners of this world to see one person who can do action unselfishly. It is very difficult to perform actions unselfishly. So that is the ideal of Karma Yoga. But generally people do karma for their selfish purpose. Even if they say charity, it is because their photo will come in the press or in internet, or they will get some medal or something in Lions Club or Rotary Club. That is why they do. So that is why they do the charity. So that is not acceptable. You have to throw it away. Dehad dehadau vasati tyajatma dishanam pragyam kurushu atmani. So all these, your identification with what? All asati, dehadav asati, all these unreal things like body, etc. What is body, etc.? Body, mind, prana, all these things you have got a identification with these things, unreal things. Give it up. Give this identification. Atma dishana tyaja. You give this self-identification with this body, mind, etc., and you apply your mind, fix your mind on Atman, your true nature. Tvam drashta asya manosi nirdvayaparam brahmasi yat vastutah. You are actually what? You are actually drashta. You are just the witness, and you are asya manosi nirdvayaparam. You are not, what you call, disturbed by the mind. This Atman is not disturbed by the mind. You are not disturbed by the mind. And Nirdvaya Param, it has got no second. It is Advaya. It is Advaya. So you are Tvam Drashtasi. You are Amanosi. You are not connected with the mind. You are drashta, you are just the witness, and you are one without the second. Brahma asi yad vastutah, and you are supreme, you are Brahman. So know this, and so give up all attachments to all your body, mind, actions, and also your caste, your lineage, and station in life, etc., and give up hope or craving for sense objects. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat.